Dr. Buford, we're just getting started on the right shoulder. We're looking in from the back to the front. Everything that you see is magnified 30 or 40 times on the screen. And we did examine your shoulder before we started, and it was loose to the back and to the front, which is what we expected. And now we're going to go ahead and take our first look at the anatomy. Here's your biceps tendon here. Remove this metal cannula so it's behind the biceps, like that. Then we have another gray plastic cannula coming in here. And what we're going to do is look at the biceps anchor. A little bit frayed, but it's really not loose, which is a good thing. See that right there? I'm looking down at 6 o'clock on the screen, just below the gray cannula. A little frayed, but not loose. I'm going to rotate and we'll look towards the back of the shoulder. And like I said, you get some instability posteriorly. Well, it's curious. It doesn't really look that loose back here, but we're going to look from the front to the back in a minute. As I look there, so more than likely, we're going to be putting an anchor in down at 5 o'clock and one at 7 o'clock to tighten up the inferior glenohumeral ligament. Okay, so now we're looking from the front to the back, so let me give you the overall view. You can see how now this does look a lot looser than it was before. We're going to use this instrument called the RASP just to roughen up the capsule back here. We are going to use an anchor down here because we're worried that the labrum by itself is a little bit thin. It may not give us enough fixation. But with this instrument, we're just trying to roughen up the capsule as you see here. We're not trying to make any holes. Just to give us enough of a healing response that it'll heal. And that's the labrum there that we're touching there. Okay. And so now we'll take a spinal needle, and we're going to try and find a good angle to place the suture anchor down. Take an instrument just to pass one of the sutures to the front. Okay. Do you want to go to break? Okay, so now we have the sutures organized the way we want them. So now we're going to use an instrument called a suture hook. This is it here. It's loaded with a black wire called the super shuttle. You can see it coming out of the tip there. And now in order to make this first stitch, we're going to start here, turn back, and we're going to come through the capsule down low here. both sutures passed. Now we're going to tie a knot here and make sure that closes down the, this posterior aspect of the joint like we want it to. Okay, now you got to read. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and clip the suture tails from the first knot. There it is. And the decision we've got to make is, do we tighten up a little bit more? And I think I am going to. I'm going to place another anchor here, even if we just do a simple stitch, just because the primary direction of your instability really seemed to be posterior. So we will get that organized and switched in a minute, Father.
Why do you want to know?
Right.
Why do you want to know?
Okay, so we are... Okay, so we're getting ready to make our second stitch. You can see the anchor. We're going to come into the capsule right about here. Okay, recording. Okay, so we've got two mattress sutures in the back. That really has tightened things up a bit. We're going to look to the front. And actually, as we look to the front now, that anterior band of the IGL looks pretty good. Look at that. So I may not have to do anything in the front. I'm actually going to have a look around and make that decision in just a minute. Okay, recording. Okay, so we're looking... Can we get a math report? We're looking down the front, and I just want to check the tension on this band here. And I'm pretty happy with that. I'll tell you what, Desiree, I don't think I'm going to do anything to that to make it too tight. We've already tightened up the back, which was the main thing we wanted to do. I think the last thing I'm going to do is to place a stitch through this posterior portal just to close it up. Show you how we do that here. We're going to take a spinal needle. And initially we're going to pass it. Right here. Take a little bit more over here, like right there. And now through that needle we're going to pass an absorbable stitch. Second pass through the capsule. You can see once we tie this, it's going to close down the. Here's our stitch across the capsule, across the posterior portal, through the capsule, and that looks good. And I think we're done. We're going to finish up here and get you back to the recovery room shortly, okay? So good luck to you now. Bye-bye.